Not too shabby. She dried out nice overnight. Little dust settled in it overnight, but not too bad. Right, I think I'm gonna go ahead and start getting everything untaped and get the wheels put back on it. I'm gonna let those arms up, untape them, get my straps out. He's got a couple parts here, like his back seat. I'm gonna lay it in there. Just kind of tinker with it, get it ready in case he wants to take it. He said he's coming over about 10 o'clock this morning, so I figure I'll go ahead and get that. If he decides he wants to take it, it's ready for him. All right. Well, guess I'll start untaping. Ew. Let's move you in here a little closer. Guess I'll climb up in. A little dirty, it'll clean. Looks like the inside is all untaped. Now I gotta raise it up and get everything underneath. I guess I can get this stuff all untaped first. Hey, there's that roll of tape I was hunting for. Right where I left it. Thank you.
working on a little budget this morning, but that's all right. Okay, I'm gonna raise it on up. Ryan Shane spent all that money on papers, but throw it away like that. Get the wool blankets out of there. Looks like 3/4. Okay. He said he's gonna set tricks going on this thing. But I guess the wheels are a little thicker than these, so he's gonna change the wheel studs out. They're gonna make them longer. Thank you. missing a lug nut on this wheel. Turned that heat on and knocked the chill off this morning. It got quite warm in here. Today actually would have been a better day for a shooting clear, but I was told it was supposed to rain for the next 7 days. Sweet. Well, wagon sets up a little bit in the back, don't it? Oh, I didn't know that. That works. It's pink in there. Climb up in there and get them straps.
Stranger.
Hey buddy, how you doing?
I'm doing good. I don't know if Mark will be back in time, but if he's back before 1 o'clock, we'll try to get over here because he went to an auction. Or sell us. When I done that white car, I did it by hand.
Huh?
By hand.
This is what I'm doing.
No, I'm
oh, you mean?
I don't remember even having the block.
Really?
I might have, but I can't remember good by hand. Now, is that regular water or that soapy water?
Soapy water.
That's what I thought.
I use
dish soap. Yeah, I think that's what I use too.
Keeps it from building up in the paper and just kind
of. I had like 1,000 pounds worth of orange peel.
There ain't a whole lot in this.
It ain't super bad.
The way that weather was yesterday, I was worried about it.
But you had probably good and warm in here.
When I first started.
Yeah.
When I first started, I had it up to 80 degrees. And about halfway through, it started pouring down rain.
Yeah.
And that temperature dropped. Kicked that heat up, and that's when I started noticing the dust.
Yep.
Let's just see how this thing's going to stay.
It was a rainy day. It was a rainy morning.
And then today, it was supposed to rain.
Well, it probably will sometime today.
But it looks like today would have been a better day to clear. I don't know. It turned out nice.
Yeah, it always turned out excellent.
I got 3 heavy coats and then 1 flow coat. Well, there you go. That didn't take much at all.
Yeah. Pretty smooth too, man.
Mm-hmm. That's 2,000 grit.
Is it?
All right, now that I made it ugly, take her home. All right, look how smooth that is. You can see if it'll show up in the video. I don't know if you can see those little specks of dust or not. But it didn't take much to knock that down. He decided he wanted me to go ahead and do a quick buff just to smooth out the dust, and that way he don't have to. No, I don't blame him. All right, so I guess I'm gonna be wet sanding. I know I'm not working on blowing budget, but that's all right. That's all right. I want to complete the job. I'm going to get this thing opened up today and let it set all weekend. Like I said before, it's always good to let it flash off like that. Since I don't have a bake booth, after you clear them, you can open that surface up. And it'll let it cure out down in. Let it set for a day or so. And then you can come back and hit it with 3,000. It don't take a whole lot. But hit it with 3,000 and ready for buff. Now this is what I call a quick buff. I am not getting all the edges and stuff like that. I'm just knocking the worst of it out and any dust or light orange peel, stuff like that. there ain't a whole lot, that's for sure. Pretty happy with that. I'm gonna go get my squeegee here in a second. I'm gonna get my squeegee and clean that off. Take your time, do a little at a time. You don't want to overwork. And see, now I got a speck there and a speck there. No problem. That's why I'm doing a little at a time, so I don't have to do too much. Letting the block sand it. I'm not putting force down because that'll leave grooves in it. And when you buff it, it'll look like a wave. And if you notice, I'm not setting my bottle on the car. If I do, I set it on top of a rag. I never set a hard surface on the paint. Don't like doing that with primer either. Sometimes I do. I mean, the primer sanded it out anyways. I don't want to overwork my hands either. I had a feeling he'd want me to do this. It's all good. Kind of felt bad sending it out without it done, because paint job's not complete unless you buff it. Figure a couple days this thing will be all shiny like a penny. Another thing I don't like, rubbing my fingers on the fresh paint either. Mine are really rough. Sides won't take near as much as the tops. I can pretty much sand a car with my hands.
Let's see what she looks like. Still a little bit of dust up there. You know the clear laid out nice if all you're using's 2000 grit. And it's coming out like this. Anything up here? All right. I love using this squeegee. Makes it real nice. Beautiful. I think I'm going to throw you guys on time lapse for a bit. All right, that's a light sand, and basically what that's doing, it'll highlight the dust. Getting rid of the shine, and then the dust will have a shiny spot around it. So that's when you keep sanding those areas and get them down smooth.
All right. Now on to the roof. Told him I really didn't want to do the roof because, man, it's hard to reach. But I put 1200 on the DA. I went over that. I'm going to get it down like this right here. And then I'll go over it with 2000 by hand just to do the final. I'm just knocking all the tops of the dust off. And yeah, the top's got some dust. That's a lot of square footage, guys. Yeah. All right, here I go. I got the rest of the roof down to 1200. Just like the Amish says when you try to buy firewood on a Sunday, not today. But not today. All I wanted to do, oh, not today. Yes, I've had that happen. I'm gonna get it down to the stripe all the way around with 2000 other than the roof. I ain't doing that today. Man,
paper's just a little small. This won't take that long. I know. I didn't work on blowing budget at all today. That's all right. That's quite all right. Think I'm gonna have to cut me another piece. I don't like that. Keep flipping out on me. It won't take long to do that roof. I just don't feel like leaning over it. Running the DA, I can reach out a little bit farther than by hand. I mean, after all, it is Saturday, right? Come on, man. There ain't just a whole lot of dust on the sides. It shouldn't take much at all. Yep, this is helping my tendonitis. It is starting to get better though. I don't want to overdo it. Come on, man. Gonna make me mad here in a minute. That'll work. I'm gonna get me a better piece of sandpaper though.
I grabbed 400. That ain't good. You know, I thought it looked a little funny. Well, just added more work to myself. I'm gonna have to go to 1200 and then jump it up. Alright. Let's start over. Alright. Squeegee it off. Yeah, big difference. All right, let that dry a minute and then I'll show you the difference. Okay, this was the 400, then 1200. This is 400. See the difference in it? This is 2000. And I figured out why I grabbed the wrong paper. I'm out of 2000. Apparently, one sheet of 2000 was put in with the 400. And then I come back here. I don't know how well that'll show up, but this corner got some dirt throwed into it and cleared over top. I'm gonna have to re-clear or re-shoot the white right there and re-clear it. Dang it. All right, well, it ain't happening today. I can't continue to sand because I don't have any 2000. And I'm not gonna tackle that today. I'm gonna have to tape it off real good, wet sand it. I'll sand it, no, I don't know, 400. Shoot the white on that quarter panel again. Shoot the clear on that quarter panel again. And then continue. So I'm gonna have to get some 2000 grit sandpaper coming in. Well, it's Saturday. That just ruined my work day. Oh well, it is what it is what they say. So, I guess I'll cut out for the day. I can't do anything else on it, and I ain't gonna get all dirty and everything on the blown budget at this point of the day. It's already 2:30, so I'm going home.